Hey everybody, in this video we're going to be showing you how to grow your email database using the new Zapier integration with ManyChat for Facebook Messenger bots. This is exciting.
So you can ask people in Facebook Messenger for their email and that automatically gets updated in whatever email service provider you are using, be that MailChimp or ConvertKit or AWeber or so on.
We're super, super excited about this and you should be too. So before we show you exactly how to do this for free, we want to hear from you first. How are you getting on with bots? What do you think about them? Let us know in the comments and why not pop a link to your Facebook page or your bot and we can go check it out.
Also, why not hit that subscribe button too?
So let's dive in and show you how to use this new Zapier integration with ManyChat. And at the end, we'll show you some cool things you can do with your bot to get more subscribers.
The robots are taking over. First of all, there are some prerequisites that you do need to have.
Number one,
a ManyChat Pro account, which is $10 a month for up to 500 subscribers.
Number two,
a Zapier account, obviously, or a Zapier account. Zapier, I don't know how you pronounce that. Zapier. Let us know that in the comments too. Which can be free or you might need to pay for it depending on how many zaps you have going currently.
Number three,
an email service provider. Now you need one that links with Zapier, which all the popular ones do, be that MailChimp or AWeber or ConvertKit or Infusionsoft, any of those guys.
Step one is to go into ManyChat and click on settings over here in the bottom left corner. And then you're gonna wanna click on custom fields and this is what we're going to be setting up. So let's just do test. You can leave this on text. That's all we want on at the moment. Feel free to give this a description if you want and just click create. Step two is to actually ask people for their email address. So you can do this within sequences or you can do this from a growth tool. What we're doing here is just we set up a messenger reference test growth tool to get this done and show you how it works really quickly. So what we're gonna do is just edit this text that's pre-populated, okay? And we're gonna get rid of it all and we're gonna use this user input button here, okay? Instead, I've just already put that in. I'm gonna say, hey, first name. What's your best email address?
Now we're just keeping this super simple. You probably want to give them a better reason for giving you their email address than just blatantly asking.
But exactly.
Let's keep this let's keep this simple. Step three.
We're gonna put that onto email. Another cool thing here is that if someone actually types in the email address wrong, it actually auto-corrects them and says, hey, did you actually, you know, mean to type it like this? Which is cool. And then what we're going to do is save that answer to a custom field. And remember, we've just created this test email custom field. So that's why we had to do that beforehand. If you want to also tag people that have added in their email address, that's also something that you might want to do. And then you might want to just put in some kind of text afterwards, after they've replied with the email, to say, thanks, we've just sent you more information to, and then what you can do is just add in the email, which is really cool. So that looks pretty cool when that comes through. That's a nice little touch. And then what you want to do is just hit on that publish button right there. So that should be all ready to go. And now we need to make sure that this links to our email service provider and also to Zapier.
So we're using ConvertKit here, but this does work on MailChimp, AWeber, any of the most popular ones. And what we've done is we've created a form. It might be a list or something else that you've created, depending on the terminology that your email service provider uses. In ConvertKit, we're creating a form, and everyone that subscribes to this form, we've set it up so they get automatically sent a welcome email.
Step four is to integrate this with Zapier. So at this point, you have set up your growth tool to ask people for their email address. You have set up a welcome series and a form within ConvertKit or MailChimp or whatever, and now it's finally time to connect them two together. So we want to go and make a zap in Zapier. So the trigger app that we are choosing is ManyChat, which is currently in its beta. And we're gonna select this new or updated custom field because that's what's happening. People are entering the email address into our custom fields. Click save and continue. Choose your ManyChat account. Zapier will then go and find ManyChat custom fields and give them in a drop down here. And we're just gonna choose this test email one. Click continue. Now you might wanna do a little test here. That looks great. Okay, so now we have told Zapier that if anybody enters something into this custom field to trigger a zap. So let's link that up now. At this point, you might want to search for MailChimp or AWeber or whatever you want here, but we're going to choose ConvertKit. It works pretty much the same in all email service providers like MailChimp. It works exactly the same as ConvertKit, just there'll be slight nuances on the wording.
We prefer to choose add subscriber to a form at this point because we can always add a tag or add them to a sequence after they're subscribed to a form within ConvertKit itself.
Just choose your ConvertKit account. Then this is where we choose the form that we want people to subscribe to. You can see test form here.
For email, we need to find the custom field that we've just set up in ManyChat. So that is this one here. And we can pull their first name in from ManyChat too, which is really cool. We're gonna switch this opt-in to course to no because we can always do this from ConvertKit itself. So we're just gonna keep this as clean as possible.
And then when you're ready, just click continue.
Now we're getting an error message here because Sarah on our list hasn't actually filled out that custom field yet. So we're just gonna skip this test and continue.
And we're gonna hit continue to finally finish this. We're gonna name that. All right, there we go. Your zap is working, hopefully. Fingers crossed.
So step 5 is just to test that this all works.
So we're gonna go back to this growth tool that we set up, and if you just click on setup here, we're gonna copy this URL to our clipboard. So whenever people copy this or type it in, then they're gonna be sent this messenger bot message. So if we go to a new tab here, boom, as you can see right there, hey Peter, what's your best email address? Okay, so if I was to type in something wrong here and press enter, it would tell me that this is wrong. So that's pretty cool. So let's put in a proper email address and we hit enter and we get the thank you message. Thank you, we've just sent you more info to, and then our email address that we've just typed in. Boom, it has worked. I can get this as a new subscriber in that form with a welcome email sent. Bob's your uncle, that's how it's done.
One of the biggest complaints that we get about messenger bots is that Facebook owns all of that data. It's not your own, that whole marketing cliche of don't build on rented land, kids. But using this Zapier integration, you can actually use messenger bots really effectively to grow your own email list.
And in some cases, we've actually found this a lot easier to convert people to our bot subscriber first, and then to enter the email address, as opposed to the traditional way of just sending people to a landing page to fill out a form with a name and an email. Which is crazy, right? How is this easier? Mm-hmm. This is so cool.
Here's a cool post we did for our new show,
which launched last week, so go check it out, people.
This got people to comment with the word show to be part of the pre-party guest list, and then our Facebook Messenger bot kicked in and asked them for their email address for further information. Ooh.
I feel like we're on this exciting cusp right now of all this amazing things that are happening with messenger bots. Getting people onto your email list now means that this is a serious way to grow your business, and I'm really excited.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and if you are brand new to bots and have just spent the past few however minutes thinking, what the hell are those two talking about? Go check out this video over here. It's an introduction to how you can be using bots in your marketing. We cover all of the basics.
I really hope that you have enjoyed that. He's been Andrew. I've been Pete. Please make sure that you subscribe and leave a comment with your Facebook page or bot, and we'll check it out.
See you next time.
It's all this arm movement outside of camera.
I'm such a hand talker.